Hey, what's up guys, welcome back to another one, and welcome to the first hands-on that I've had with the Yamaha MT-09 SP 2021. I must say I'm a bit undecided about the front headlight, but everything about this new bike is awesome. The new bike is really, really amazing. This year they finally introduced downshifting as well on the quick shifter, which is amazing. I can't wait to try it out. Then they've also did some aesthetic changes to the bike, which again, it looks really, really good. I'm a bit undecided about the headlight. I'm not a big fan, I must say. And I'm also not a big fan of the rear swing arm. So they've changed it from black to silver. So I can't say I'm very pleased with that either. So the first one was the quick shifter. You've now got the downshifts as well, which is amazing. You've got cruise control. So I don't know if anyone follows this channel, but I commute on the bike. I do a lot of miles on it. I think I do about 15,000 to 20,000 miles a year. Most of it is on a motorway, highway. Depends how you call it, wherever you're from. And I've always said I wish that Yamaha would have put a cruise control on the bike. And they finally done that, which is amazing. I'm really, really pleased about that. And I think a lot of people that were in doubt about buying the bike will probably jump on it, considering that it now has the cruise control, you've got the new quick shifter, and you've got an improved engine on something that was already top notch. So I'm just going to give you a quick look of the bike. You can see the rear swing arm, the silver one. Not a big fan, but yeah, looks alright. Then the exhaust, they've changed it from the previous one. Apparently it's noisier, it has a bit more grunt in it. It's not as silent as the previous one. They've improved the engine as well. So they've done loads of changes to the engine, increased CC, increased horsepower. The torque is different as well, it's even torquier. And then on the SP model, you've also got improved LED signal lights, both rear and forward. So you could say that they've done a few aesthetic changes as well. So the air intakes on the MT-09 SP look much nicer. The indicators, the side panels look better and they look more solid. The forks, they've been improved based on the previous one. Yeah, that I don't know, that light is just not. It's not for me. Maybe I just need to get used to it. I don't know. I still prefer the old headlight. I don't know, it just looks like an... reminds me very much of the Yamaha R1 2009. And I was a big fan of that, and I don't know, this new headlight, this Cyclopsy look, reminds me, I can't remember the year, but that really old Ducati from, I think it was 2001, 2002, I can't remember. You've got some anodized parts, all black, looks very nice, very neat. Again, the indicators, the side of the bike looks nice. You've got the quick shifter, up and down, good improvement. The exhaust, as I said, is revamped, completely new this year. You've got the Ohlins suspension on the rear, fully adjustable. Everyone raves about it. I'm not that much of a professional to be able to use it to its full potential, but I'm gonna trust everyone that says that it makes a huge difference. Then you've got the rear swing arm. So they've removed this year, they removed the number plate holder. They've now positioned it underneath the seat rather than having it attached to the swing arm. I don't know, I was a big fan of the number plate being attached to the swing arm, but this year I just might remove it from my bike as well and place it underneath the seat. If you look at the rear of the bike, the stoplight reminds me very much of the FZ1 that I had. Just show you a picture. Then they've done a huge improvement on the screen, so I think the screen looks amazing. It's finally a TFT screen, it's gonna be fantastic. You've got the cruise control on the left side, and I think the cruise control is something that anyone that's riding the bike on long journeys, long distance, everyone's going to appreciate it. So all in all, I think the MT-09 SP is a fantastic machine, very solid. A lot of people are going to love it. A lot of people are going to jump on it. I don't know about the price. So there's talks about the bike costing over £10,000. I think that's a bit excessive. I don't know how you feel. It's just out of my budget. I just couldn't afford to pay that much for a bike. It is what it is. Also the electronics, they've done a lot of improvements to the electronics. They've added more riding modes, more safety features to it, so that's always a positive. Yeah, that's about it. I'm really looking forward to see what you guys have to say about it. Drop a comment, let me know if you like that headlight, I'm very on the fence about it. I don't know what to say. I personally don't like it, but then again, I don't know. Once I had the hands-on, I was talking to the Yamaha rep. They were asking also a lot of questions about how I feel about the TFT, how I feel about the headlight, how I feel about the engine and the specs and everything that's coming out, how I feel about the price. And most of the people that were talking to the rep there, they were all complaining about the headlight. I mean, everything else people liked except the price and the headlight. Let me know in the comments how you feel about it. Drop me a comment and catch you in the next one. Peace out, people.